Remember the story of Abraham and Isaac. Abraham and Sarah had waited for a little boy. And by a miracle, a little boy was born, and they named him Isaac. And when he was just a lad, God said, Abraham,
you take your son, your only son, to a mount that I will show you, Mount Moriah.
He didn't just say any place. You go to a particular place. What was this place? It was Mount Moriah.
God comes to Abraham and he says, Abraham, I want you to take this son. Notice it says, the son you love. And I want you to take him to the mountain that I will tell you about. And there on that mountain, I want you to sacrifice him to me.
He takes a servant with him and takes his son, and he goes to that Mount Moriah.
Now, Abraham and Isaac start up Mount Moriah. The others cannot go. Abraham says to the others, you stay here. The lad and I are going to worship God.
The first time worship is ever mentioned in the Bible is in connection with Abraham giving up his son, whom he loved so much because God asked him to, and that, my friend, is true worship.
What does the Bible say worship was? It was Abraham offering to God the very best that he had, his own son.
Can you imagine the suffering of Isaac looked at his father,
and he asked his father, he says, where is the sacrifice? And Abraham said, God will provide. He stretches out on an altar willingly, and Abraham at the last minute takes a knife when God speaks from heaven and says, stay thine hand.
God says, Isaac, there is a sacrifice that's going to take your place. And Abraham looks up, and there is a ram crowned with thorns. And God says, take that and sacrifice him instead of Isaac. What a picture of Calvary.
God was pointing to the day, hundreds of years in the future, when he would offer his own son as the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world.
And when this was all over and Abraham was able to step back from it for a moment and realize how God had instantly provided what he needed, he named that mountain Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide.
God takes one mountain and he calls that mountain my holy hill. Now, what was so important about that? Do you know where Moriah is and was? Friend, Moriah is Calvary. Calvary. That's where the temple was built, on Moriah. That's where Jesus died, on Moriah.
That ram was nothing more than a type and shadow of the Lamb of God that would be sent to Mount Moriah centuries later. God would send his only begotten son as a substitute for you and for me.
God said, there is a substitute. I will provide. And Abraham says, Jehovah Jireh, God will provide. God will provide. He's going to provide redemption. He's going to defeat hell. He's going to defeat the devil. He's going to defeat every demon power. He's going to defeat every power of darkness. God has promised he will provide.
There is a God in heaven who saw man in his sin, but determined that man would not go to hell, and sent his only son to be born of a virgin and die on Calvary's cross and shed his blood that we might be redeemed today.
He loved us so much that he would not spare his own son, but delivered him up so that we might be forgiven of our sin. Because you see, the Bible says the wages of sin is death, and the wages had to be paid. And so God sent his son, Jesus Christ, into this world.
God loves us that much that he would send his son to take Franklin Graham's sins and die and shed his blood on a cross for Franklin Graham. And if anyone puts their faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, he will give us eternal life and we will be with him forever.
How do you get saved? Number one, you have to admit that you're a sinner. Number two, you have to believe that what Jesus did on Calvary is the only remedy for sin. By grace are you saved? Through faith. Faith in who? Jesus Christ. Faith in him. What did he do? He died on Calvary and shed his blood for your sins and mine.
All it takes is one step of faith. And say, Jesus, I believe that you died for my sins. I believe that I'm a sinner. I believe that I need you. You died to save me. I believe.
Every one of you, no matter who you are or where you are, heaven and eternal life is just as close as the two words, I believe.